There are multiple ways to color grade. Color, at the end of the day, is subjective. What I will be showing you today is the more technical or scientific way, but with that said, I am no expert colorist. So before we start, you need to download the conversion LUT from Panasonic. And you can do that by clicking the link down in the description box. After you download it, you want to open your vlog footage and bring it into Premiere. And we're not going to be talking about exposure and how to take the image, because taking the image is very important. Coloring is very based around that. So once you open it, all you need to do is go to the Colors tab, go into the Basics correction, put Input LUT. You might see it in this drop-down folder. If you don't, you would most likely have to find it on your computer. So you would select Browse. It might be in your Downloads folder. Just make sure you know where it is, find it, click the Cube version, and press Open. And there, I would say that was a very fast and quick way to color correct. That's how you would do it. You would also maybe have to play with the saturation in the Creatives tab, maybe play with the shadows and highlights a bit more. I mainly wanted to highlight the use of the conversion LUT for this video. What I see a lot of people do is that they would bring the footage straight from their camera into Premiere, and they would just add some contrast to the footage and give it some more saturation. So this isn't necessarily wrong. If you like the way this looks, then by all means, keep on doing it. However, I don't think that this is the most technical or accurate approach. To talk more about it, let's learn more about vlog footage from Panasonic themselves. You can find this article in the description box below. You probably already know this, but log recorded images are used to provide the greatest possible flexibility for later color correction. They are not intended to be viewed directly. What you probably didn't know was that a conversion LUT translates the flat vlog material to a more restricted yet contrasty dynamic range and shifts the color space to match the monitor, bringing both parameters to a technical standard for viewing such as Rec 709. And so by simply adding the contrast and giving it more saturation, without the conversion LUT, you're making changes in a color space that's not quite intended for viewing. And so that's why I like using a conversion LUT. I'm getting the right color science, the right contrast, the right saturation that Panasonic designed vlog footage to be. At least that's what I think this conversion is doing. Please let me know. Again, I'm not a colorist by all means, but this is the workflow that I like to have. So what we did just now is called color correction. But how do you stylize your footage even further? The left panel in this panel right here, typically, you want to click this icon for a new item and click adjustment layer. This will pop up. You just drag this over your clip so that you can make color adjustments to this instead of right into the video itself. And now we're really entering a place where it's very subjective. Panasonic also offers creative and artistic LUTs, not just the technical conversion LUTs. And Panasonic says the creative LUTs are used by combining the technical conversion and the creative changes. So for color grading, you would use both the conversion LUT and their creative LUT. So with this footage, we added the conversion LUT and did some color correction. Then on the adjustment layer, again, you can download those in the link in the description. Once you download them, you do the same process as the conversion LUT with a few different changes. Okay, so you're gonna go to the Creatives tab, go to the Look, drop-down menu, select Browse, locate where the LUTs are on your computer. Let's say I wanna go with Cyan. One, we just open that up, and boom, there you have the look. And I know it looks very intense right now, but that's why we have in the Creatives tab to be able to lower the intensity. So let's say right about there. With further refinements and adjustments, you know, maybe I want the more shadows in my midtones to lift because I think my shadows are a little bit too dark. With little refinements like that, you can further your look. So there you guys have it with this tutorial. I just wanted to highlight the conversion LUTs and the creative LUTs. If you want a more in-depth color grading tutorial, please let me know in the comments. My name is Aaron. If you guys got value from this video, please like the video. It helps push it out to more people. But with that said, I hope I see you in the next one. Deuces.